Hello friends, and we meet today again for yet another differentiation in spotters. This is between two protozoans. Now, it is not that difficult to differentiate between a Trichomonas vaginalis and Gia d'Alamlia. But if you see, I had put up a poll, and this is 43% of people think it is Trichomonas vaginalis. So let us just quickly run through the just couple of points which differentiates Giardia from Trichomonas. Now before that, let me run through the morphological theoretical picture. So if you see to it here, this is the troposite form and this is the cyst form of a Giardia. There are two forms. So the trophozyte is the one which is actually the racket shaped or heart shaped as the textbook describes it. My first version of Gia d'Alamlia was a scary, weird doll with two scary eyes, mustache-like hair running down its eyes, and a weird, wicked smile. That is what that came to my mind the first time. But it is actually nothing but the ventral form of the protozoan with these two big things as eyes as the nuclei, the wicked smile as the parabasal bodies, the mustache-like thing as the four pairs of flagella. If you see in the lateral view, there is a sucking disc. Now this protozoan uses this sucking disc to get attached to the intestinal mucosa. And also one unique point about Giardia is this is the only protozoan that is found in small intestine. The other ones reside in the large intestine. The infective form, if you see, is the cyst. Now this cyst is definitely, you can see, different from this scary doll, I say. The cyst has a oval shaped, if you see, it has a thick cyst wall. And instead of these two big eyes, it has two pairs, that is four nuclei. A stem-like axis that you can see is the axostyle and the parabasal body, which doesn't really look like wicked smile here. And this cyst form is the actual infective form of this protozoan. That is what I mean by the infective form is if this cyst is swallowed enterically by a human being, it enters the GIT and each cyst gives form to two trophozoites, and that is how it divides by binary fission. Coming back to the slide now. So this slide the picture was taken in my second year of residency. I'm sorry for the resolution, but I wanted to show you an actual side, and I had taken this picture. Why? Because it was showing the troposite form and the cyst form in the same field. So if you can see the racket type that I had described or the heart-shaped body, you can see here in the troposite, the scary eyes that I had described as the nuclei, you can see it here. This is the central axis. And yes, in this picture, we cannot really see the flagella, but the other structures are quite apparent. And here, this is the oval cyst form. You can see clearly the dark-shaped axostyle. And here are the four forms of nuclei. This is the iodine stain of a stool sample. Now coming to what Trichomonas. Trichomonas look something like this if you take the theoretical picture. This picture I have taken from the Panikkar's book of parasitology. It has flagella on top of its head rather than below, which we see in the Giardia. It has a fifth flagella which hangs like an undulating membrane and an axostyle in the center. And unlike Giardia, it has only one eye, or you can call it one nucleus. This is how it appears in a wet mount. You can see the flagella or the undulating membrane here. You can see the body, which is not like the racket shaped as in Giardia. And yes, you won't find the scary eyes, aka the nuclei here. Now, this is a video of Trichomonas vaginalis that I had taken. This is a urine sample, wet mount of a urine sample. Observe the jerky movements done by the protozoa. Let me run it again. Can you see the flagella at the top? If you see it properly, you can see a very thin, faint flagella that comes up there. This was how morphologically it looks under a microscope, but also in a spotter, always clinical history is given of the patient. So the first and very clear-cut hint is given in the history itself. You will always find a Giarda lamblia in a pathogenic stool sample, and you will always find a Trichomonas vaginalis in a urine sample of a patient. So if you find stool, so say if the history is given as a stool sample with a person showing fat malabsorption plus diarrhea, flatulence, and if this is what is shown in the clinical, and if this is what is shown in the microscopic picture which we just discussed, then definitely you know what is your answer. And if you see this in your microscope, and if it's a female urine sample, and there is a history of recent sexual activity, then it clear cuts give you a hint, because Trichomonas vaginalis is a sexually transmitted disease. I hope these 43% people, if they are watching this video, you will never get confused between both the protozoans. And thank you for watching my video, and stay tuned for such other spotter videos.